This is my first time in the car, and it happens to be a race. Go figure. This is chassis number 868, Spec Racer Ford, that we just now put in a Gen 3 motor. We didn't get to practice or qualify with the car because it wasn't ready. We barely got it ready for this race. As a matter of fact, we had to push start it because we had trouble with the starter. We had to push start for this race. There's a nice little accident coming up here in turn one. I'm intentionally laying back because they put me in the back, position 32. And the last thing I want to do is test the car during a race and then get in an accident. So I back off and let everybody do what they want to do. Anyway, at this point, I'm trying to learn the car. I don't know the suspension settings or anything since I've never driven the car. I don't know how it's going to handle. I don't even know what my shift points are because now we have a rev limiter at 6,750 RPMs. And I don't know what gear I need to be in for each turn, so I'm having to figure that out as I drive along. In the meantime, I think I'll just sit back and relax, figure out the car before I start trying to pass people. Anyway, listen to the motor. Notice that when I pass, the passing speeds as compared to a Gen 2. Car in front of me is Spec Racer Sports number 6. David Perkins, the CSR, got the motor before private individuals like myself got the motor. So he got the beta tested while the SCCA Enterprises developed the new kit. I have a different exhaust and probably put out a few more horsepower. But in the meantime, I'm still trying to learn the car. But just notice the closing speeds and how much quicker the Gen 3 passes than the Gen 2. And that wasn't even drafted. Cars still handle similarly in the turns, but you got to figure on the fact that 100 pounds less weight should be helpful in the turns as well as accelerating and braking. Still trying to get comfortable with the fact that this thing will go up to about 6,500 RPM before I need to shift. I'm just not used to hearing that in a Spec Racer Ford. Takes some getting used to. Also, if you're familiar with Texas World Speedway, the shift points are completely different. There's actually no reason ever to go into fifth. Although I used 5th in this video, on Sunday I stopped using 5th going down the main straight because it just didn't make sense to shift into 5th when you still had another 200 or 300 RPMs left before you had to make your turn. Coming back out here onto the main straight, passing Gen 2s is relatively easy. Coming out of a turn, you seem to have more torque and definitely more horsepower. Now, all the Gen 2s are racing for points, so I don't want to screw them up, although I ended up doing that later on when I passed under yellow because I wasn't paying any attention. But other than that, I was trying my best not to mess up the other guy's race by being aggressive and passive. Even if I had an opportunity, I wanted to make sure it was a pass that would not hurt them too bad. At the same time, I was letting number 6 Gen 3 get away from me, so I began to decide, well, I want to race him, but in order to do that, I need to pass these cars. I still managed to piss off a few people.
Thank you.
I'll just end the video.